Wasps are a significant pest in New Zealand. They rob food from our nectar-feeding birds. They eat and compete with our native insects. They cause injury and loss of life. They impact our economy with losses of over $1 million. We now have a tool for widespread control using bait stations. Manage a wasp outbreak from the scale of a campground up to many hectares. Vespex is a protein-based bait specifically formulated to target wasps. It is not attractive to bees. It has very low toxicity for birds and mammals, including people. Wasp stations keep the active ingredient contained, away from water and wildlife. The Vespex Wasp Control Program has four distinct phases. The key tasks of each phase follow. Plan for activity testing. We'll explain what this is shortly. Map out the treatment area. Check you have all the equipment you'll need. Plan how you will store the Vespex, which needs to be kept frozen. Consider the people your wasp operation will affect. When on public conservation land, plan for conversations with people on adjoining land. Allow time for the DOC permission process. Activity testing is the most important phase. It collects evidence that wasp density is high and that the wasps are feeding on protein. You may need to test more than once before you reach the required activity threshold. Once your test is positive, it is time to execute your wasp control program. We recommend putting out stations at least a day ahead of baiting to help manage gear. 3 to 8 days after baiting, plan to remove bait from the environment. Best practice requires that you refer to the documentation and the label before, and ring the operation. Let's look at each phase in more detail. Planning should be done well in advance on a large-scale operation. Wasp stations can be spaced up to 50 meters along a bait line. Parallel bait lines can be separated between 50 to 300 meters apart. Draw the treatment area boundary on your map. Mark bait lines and stations. See the product label for further grid spacing guidance. Identify all site access points and mark these on your map. Plan to have enough notification signs for each access point. Vespex is supplied frozen in a tub and should be stored frozen until used. Separate Vespex from where frozen food is stored. Stewardship requirements for Vespex are equal to vertebrate toxic agent controls. When planning an operation on public conservation land, you will need to apply for DOC permission, which requires evidence of planning, communication and consultation. This includes evidence of consultation with iwi, beekeepers and adjoining landowners. The Ministry of Health and the District Council must also be notified. The application requires evidence of an assessment of environmental effects. Search the DOC website for guidance on the permission application process. On private land, the requirement is for signage at all legitimate public access points to the treatment area. Activity testing. Wasp activity is the number of wasps attracted to protein bait after a set time. To ensure Vespex's mode of action will be effective, wasp activity must pass a threshold. Activity testing is essential. Canned fish is an effective attractant when preserved in spring water and not oil or brine. Fresh fish offcuts can also be used. Plan to do your activity testing at the same location where you plan to control wasps. Run your activity test around noon, avoiding early morning or late afternoon. Avoid cold or rainy days. Pack these items for your activity test. Between 500 grams to 1 kilo of fish attractant. Exactly 20 shallow dishes such as clean jar lids. A dessert spoon for the non-toxic attractant. A notebook and pen. A rubbish bag to collect your dishes and fish waste. And don't forget your can opener if you need one. At the site, place a lid on the ground and spread out the heaped spoonful of fish. Walk out 5 meters to place the next lid, then continue laying out the lids in a straight line. Wait an hour. This allows wasps in the area to be drawn to the dishes. Then start inspecting from the first lid and record the presence of any wasps. Count the number of wasps feeding at each lid. The total number of wasps attracted is the wasp activity for the area. 10 wasps per 20 lids is the threshold for non-honeydew forest. If the total wasp count is less than 10 wasps, delay your operation. If the total count is more than 20 wasps, your operation is go for all habitats including honeydew forests. Monitor the forecasts for a fine warm period to start your operation. Operation once you have confirmed the weather for the next 3 days is warm and fine, take the bait out to thaw. Do this early in the morning so it will be completely thawed by tomorrow. Remember, good weather is essential for the duration of the operation. Otherwise wasps will not feed at the stations. Pack the following items for setting out wasp stations. Flat packed wasp stations. Screws or nails. A driver. A print out of the operation layout. Locate a tree or wall where there is at least a horizontal distance of 2 meters from water. This includes drains and ditches, rivers and lakes. Consider water amenities that drain to waterways. At each site measure where you will affix the wasp station. 70 centimeters above the ground is the legal minimum. Affix at 150 centimeters of the ground whenever possible. This reduces risk to animals and children in the area. It will reduce the chance of wildlife causing the bait to spill. Use one or two nails or screws to attach the station. Check the station is secure and will remain level. Pack the following items for baiting. Some pairs of nitrile gloves. The Vespex applicator. Bait wells. A bag for disposal. The tub of Vespex kept inside another plastic bag to manage potential spills. It is important to always keep food separate from treatment gear. You are legally required to carry the following documents when you are carrying or handling Vespex. The documentation includes a bait safety handling sheet for baits in paste form. The Vespex safety data sheet. The Vespex performance standards. And a map of the treatment area. Also remember to take the notification signs and a marker pen. The bait label is legally required to be visible on the outside of the day pack. Use the laminated card supplied. Secure it to your pack. Arrive in the treatment area early. Allow enough time so that all lines can be baited before noon. Start by visiting all the access points. Put up signs where they will be seen. Remember to fill in the sign details. Now follow the map layout to find the stations. While gloved, at each station open the tub, file the bait well to the fill line. Open the cover. Insert the bait well. And relatch the cover, clean up any spills. Always reseal the tub before moving to the next station. At the last station look at the remaining bait. It can be refrozen for next season or discarded with the bait wells. Clean up 3 to 8 days later. Take the same day pack with the label card displayed, and carry the same documents. Keep any food and drink separate. Use the empty Vespex tub or a bag to collect the bait wells. Systematically follow the map, wear gloves to remove bait from each station. Place bait wells in the rubbish bag or tub. In some areas, you can choose to leave the wasp stations in place, or take down the stations and flat pack to store for the next season. Remember to take down all public notices. Dispose of all contaminated waste. The legal requirement is that it will be sent to an approved landfill. Refer to any local requirement for ecotoxic waste disposal.